All right, pulling up Adam Mancini's tweet right now. Oh, I got a tweet from a successful trader who trades with Adam Mancini's newsletter and has been doing fairly well, but I think he only trades futures. But I like this guy. This guy's a good guy. I'll read his tweets in a moment. Let me first read Adam Mancini's tweet. Well, I'm not gonna read his tweet. You know, it's personal, but just a synopsis because I mentioned to him that I was doing a YouTube channel. Okay, from Adam Mancini. We have now been in consolidation in ES for 2 days with 3975, 4000 being pure noise. Traps. Waiting on NFP tomorrow. Oh, that's right. Unemployment comes out tomorrow. 3975 was key support yesterday and saw four bounces. Let's review that really quick. And yesterday, just before the market closed, we did a flush below 3975 and then looked like a mini rally that came back down and retested. If we look at this, I think this might be forming, I don't know if it will, a 30 minute. Yep. So just before close, we formed a clean 30 minute. I didn't even see this. See that? Although yesterday I had company, so I was distracted. But this is a good 30 minute level right here. I probably don't need to add this, but I'm going to. So yes, that was nice. And then look, here's our retest. I wish I can create an algorithm that would automatically create these levels and then give me an automatic alert if it's pulling back to that level and it gets within a certain range. It would be nice if I had some sort of setup that can create that. Interestingly though, if I did, it would likely give me a 30-minute supply here and also alert me that it was retested here. So this would be an interesting situation. Do you take this one short? Or do you take this one long? But I think the bigger key here is that this demand is appearing right next to Adam Mancini's level. So that should tell me that you would want to take this long. Anyways, okay. So we've been, oh, I should do this on SPY, this 30 minute, but 3975 to 4000 is all noise. And the bounces that happened were, I don't know if this counts as one, but probably it does. But yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, plan today, 3975-80 remain support as long as it holds above 3990 trigger 410 to 422 in play. Unfortunately, we almost just hit 410 already. So for me, I'm gonna need to see a pullback again. And I don't know if that pullback would be as far as 3975 again, because I would like to think that the bulls don't want it to go that low again. All right. I'm trying to see if I can find any patterns. I don't see any patterns. Let's go ahead and switch back to SPY. See if we can find that 30 minute. Yep, it's right here. Edit, 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 edit. No, edit. All right, let's look at the VIX. For VIX to rally, we would need to break below this. This stopped the rally yesterday, but we did break below this. I don't know if this should be something of meaning. And I also don't know if I need to adjust this 4 hour, but I'm not going to. All right. Okay, so my rules are I need to look at the big picture, but big picture patterns, I don't see anything really. I took off the megaphone. Because by now it's way too large. Or is it though? Yeah, no, it'll be like way up here. It's kind of pointless. So I don't see any major patterns. This does not look like a bear flag from yesterday's or Monday's drop. Man, Monday was a big drop. God, I should have. Anyways, I'm not gonna do that whole woulda, shoulda, coulda. All right, the bullish plan is basically what Adam Mancini says, and based on his tweet, he is bullish. So this thing should make its way to 4022, and then I think the next one was, well, he doesn't have it in his tweet, but let me see if he added any extra information, because sometimes I'll do that. I'll read his tweet and then I don't see what he adds for extra tweet. Wait, someone just tweeted, it looks like a bear flag on the 4 hour. Let's see if that's the case. No. No, if anything on the 4 hour, I just see that megaphone even better. I don't see a bear flag. But he did get a couple of likes, maybe people would agree with him. So I had mentioned to this guy, because he was saying how someone posted a tweet that I don't follow, but I guess it showed up in my feed, that you don't want to tell people that you're a trader, because when you tell people that, they will look at you like you're wasting your time and tell you you're just gambling, and that only someone with a passion for this, who's put a lot of time and effort into it, can understand that there are patterns. It isn't really gambling. And if you're really good at it, you can be quite successful. I wish I could agree fully, but I'm not at that point, obviously. And this person I follow posted on there about how his wife has been very supporting, and she's the only person who's been supporting of him, and now he is successful at it. So I posted, "Hey, sounds like you found a really good wife." I started a YouTube channel to chronicle my many failed trades, in the hopes that I can maybe get better at this. So this is his response. God, I'm sorry. I gotta get water out here. The hardest part is psychology and managing risk. $100 a day is $25,000 a year. That shouldn't be hard. But when you blow up 2 weeks' worth of profits in one session because you're revenge trading and not following your rules, you're effed. That's the hardest part for me. Then he added another tweet. It's like golf. I'm pretty good. I would shoot mid-80s consistently, but I would have to have like two or three holes where I blow it all up and end up in the hundreds. I have no idea about golf. I'll have to look up info on golf. Golfing. I actually have no idea. But I think I get the analogy. Grew up watching Formula One. did track. I didn't add a period. Why are you adding a p- Oh wow, I so despise this phone. Okay, that's enough for that. And okay, what is our bullish plan? Let's see if we have any supply demands forming pre-market, especially on ES. Yep. It looks like this 3980 level is still holding up. It's like we formed something here at 3979 and it retested. And it's just rocketing out. Maybe I don't know if I'm gonna adjust this. No, I'll leave it as it is. And unspy. Okay, what is this? I'm gonna remove this. I guess I'll add a 15 here. A retest. And should I get rid of this? I don't know, we bounced and we launched from here. Well, let's see if we can get a pullback to about here at the very least. Or here. And then we'll take that long. But I don't know if we're gonna get that pullback. Probably won't. A bearish case. I don't see any supplies forming. Well, this would have been a bearish case if we rejected from here, but we blew right past it. Although it is possible that if it was going to give a minimal pullback, that minimum pullback might end up being here. Yeah, well, here's my new roommate. It may have been getting me, may have gotten me sick. Sorry, I'm sorry. I should just end this video. I'm just reading a work I have to do. All right. Well, we've got 4 minutes until the market opens. I don't know. I did put money in the account. Yeah, I think I need to take a good hot shower. I did put extra funds in the account. Unfortunately, I lost $5 of those funds yesterday. And Monday was just a really bad trading day. It really, really shouldn't have been. So I'll return if I see a demand forming. So, excuse me. I'll be back later. Okay, I missed the bell. I was on the phone, and what I should have done was set up my option. So that was already done a dumb mistake for the day. And targeted 402. Now, look what happened. Exactly what I thought might happen. So I called this one. We got a very minor pullback right to previous resistance from yesterday. And then subsequent pop. So if I had put a buy in right around here, I could have gotten in the low 30s and will already be up almost 20 bucks. I'm not really stressing it. If things work out with this new roommate, and I kind of like her, look at that pop. I'm gonna wait for a day when I have a good, confident feeling on a trade and take that trade with a sizable, well, with my small account, whatever you can call sizable, For example, if I had, say, 300 in my account, well, let's say over 300, although I don't know if I would have taken this one for sure. This doesn't feel too confident boosting. But if I had, let's say if I had set my buy-in right about here, and I would have gotten in maybe 31, 32, I guess, I don't know. Set my sell at 51, 52. That's 200 bucks right there. But I may be wrong, but I have a feeling today is going to be chop. But then again, the way the market works, the market sometimes knows that people are waiting on a catalyst, so the market will just rally anyways. And there we go. It looks like that's what it's doing. Or that's what it's been doing since 8 a.m. So I don't know if some news came out this morning that hold on. Oh my God, I hate computers. Okay. Trading. There you go. You know what? I need to put this on the home screen. I don't know how to do that. Is there some way I can put this on the home screen? Whatever. So that was yesterday. I don't know why they're showing yesterday. Oh, I guess that makes sense, yeah. Oh. So that was it. I thought NFP was tom oh, NFP is tomorrow, but apparently initial jobless claims was higher than the previous one, and that's actually good news when more people are being unemployed because that helps inflation, helps battle inflation. Fed bar speech. I don't know how much of an effect that's going to be at 10 a.m. But tomorrow, the unemployment rate and non-farm payroll is going to be closely watched. Let's see what's up for next week. Oh, is this CPI? Because I don't understand why they don't list CPI anymore. It's core inflation rate year over year. PPI. Wednesday. Building permits. Yeah, okay. Well, on SPY, we are back to that 4007. I mean, I'm sorry, not on SPY, on ES. Actually, this is interesting. On SPY, we're at 400. On ES, we're at 4006. Finally, they've both kind of merged so that they're sort of the same. Because earlier this year, SPY can be at 4200. I mean, God, ES can be at 4200 and SPY is like at 398 or something. It was ridiculous. But 4010 is the next target, I believe, for Adam Mancini. Then after that is 4022. Just trying to verify that on this tweet really quick. Yeah, 410 then 40, 4010, 4010 then 4022. So, this is going to continue pushing. And on SPY, I have a weekly resistance just above. Oh, and I have still have this at 10:30. I just realized that. Let's see. I want to zoom out a bit. Yesterday, our flush was below the bull flag. That's something else I didn't really realize. Although that's what it looks like here. Did I take log scale off? That's what happens. I turn it on. Yeah, it's a big difference there. I don't understand. That's significant change. This looks like a spot where we'll reject, and that will be interestingly around 4010 on ES. Anyways, it could be that we're just gonna slowly grind up for the rest of the day and then maybe pull back just before close. I'm not really sure. Or we may come back down and retest this again. But anyways, I'm just gonna wait and see until we form a 15-minute supply and demand. I'm gonna zoom in on the 30 so I don't miss out on that like I did yesterday. Oh, and on VIX, on VIX, we're down to this daily, so we need to break under this for this rally to continue, but it looks like that's about to happen any moment. And then we just will pop down to, we'll pop up to here. Which makes me think I should probably take this long if we retest this previous resistance. But being honest, I'm not really into, I'm now that I've put more money into my account again, I'm not really into trading, which means I probably should trade. But let's follow the plan. Let's wait for a 15-minute demand or supply to be formed. I may not wait for a retest, depending on how close we are to a level of Adamantini's. Well, then again, his next level support still is 3975, 3980. That's still way down here. Or actually here. Up. Yep. The book that I'm reading now, The Psychology of Trading, I forget the title, the author, whatever, but one of the things he said was, in trading, it is best to often go against your instincts. And my instinct was that this is probably not a good day to trade, and I was wrong. We've now pushed to 4010, first target for Adamantini, and just blew past it. Very likely 4022 is up next, meaning had I gotten in shortly after the bell, I would have made 100% profits if I got in on one option. Would have been nice if I got in the two options. I would have made up for my losses last week, this week, and last week if I had gotten in here. I saw this pullback here and thought about getting in here and didn't. Again, another stupid mistake. And I think this is when I was saying that I wanted to wait for a better setup. Or wait for the supply and demand to be formed. Should have got in. Should have got in. And on VIX, right when this started to pop and rally, on the VIX, we broke down this daily. As you can see, not much resistance for a while, except for this 4 hour. So this thing should push. But Adamantini just tweeted right now here, precise technicals to start off in ES. 4010 was first target, off 397580 support. That was support from yesterday. And we, well, it was also support tonight. It also bounced tonight over a pre-market and held and just hit 4010 first target. Lock in gains, leave risk-free runner. 4022 and then 4035 40 next up. Now that ES pushed, ideally 3995 4K holds, or it's back the chop again. So we have an opportunity to come back in long if this pulls back to daily and then rejects. If ES goes back down to 4005 and then pops, or if SPY gets back down to 400 and then pops, but I don't see that happening. We're almost already approaching 4022, so this was a missed opportunity, unfortunately. Definitely should have taken this long shortly after the bell. I mean, we got the bounce right where I thought we would, literally right almost to the dollar at this resistance from yesterday, and it's just pushing. only thing I can do now, I suppose, is wait and see if we can get a little bit of a pullback and I can get in. But this is where I get that deer in the headlight sensation. Am I missing out, or should I just jump in? I mean, I do have the funds to get in now at one option. Yeah, I think the best bet is to wait for this to pull back a little bit. And let's see if we can get back down to. I'm going to actually use the VIX. I'm going to see if we can get back. Create alert. Above. Right? Yeah, above. If we can pull back and reject at this daily and see what happens there. Oh my God. Sorry, I need to go in the shower. This is what I wanted to do. So this is either the rejection at or near 4020 target. Yeah, almost to the dollar at 4020. Although, since 410 was the next target, 4010 was the last target, I wonder, is it possible we might bounce there? We might pull back here and bounce? Which is confluent to my weekly support here. It would have been great if I did futures and I was able to trade earlier. Instead of having to wait for 8:30, I could just trade here. You know what's funny too is yesterday when this dipped down, at some point yesterday, I don't remember what it was, I took a look at a swing. I think it was 402 that I was looking at. Same one here. And I looked for a swing yesterday, but I didn't have enough money in my account at the time to get in. But look what a great swing this would have been if you had gotten in somewhere here for a couple hundred. I mean, this wouldn't look too good, but if you're patient and waited, that's good. Anyways, it looks like. Looked like we did come close to, but not quite to 410 for the bounce. So my question is, should I go in now? Or wait till it pulls back a little bit more towards 410? Let me go back to SPY. I'll go back to our weekly. Or should I really wait for this to come back to 4005, which is now support for Adam Mancini? You know what? Let's do that. Let's just play it safe. We'll put an alert right here. Below. If we pull back then we'll take it long. I think I actually watched a video, even though this isn't the sort of clean supply and demand that I've spoken about. I've seen a recent video from NK, And this still is considered a demand right here. And let's change this. And this. Although I don't know if we're going to get much of a pullback to that spot, but it's possible. Anyways, I don't want to make this too long of a video, considering that I haven't made any trades, so. But I should have not listened to my instinct this morning. Consider that this resistance is going to now be support. Should have changed the color accordingly and taken this trade this morning. How are we on the VIX? A very minor pullback on the VIX. I may have set this alert too close though. That seems a bit more reasonable. Let's see. All right, we'll see what happens. I'm surprised I didn't notice this before. This is the trend line from the October lows, if I recall. And it has had an effect before. A rejection here, a rejection here. It looked like it may be support here, but it failed. And here we are back again. But it looked like we may be forming a supply, but bulls have turned this around. You know what? I don't think I'm going to get much more of a pullback than this. Let's do this. Let's just see what we get. That's what I thought. Oh well, I'm not gonna risk much. 59, over here, 52. I'll risk 51. What I'm hoping is that we can get back up to 4020, which isn't going to be a big profit, but I'll happily take even just 10 bucks at this point. Although I don't think that's 4020 just yet. But I'll just leave it there anyways. Isn't that crap when it gets right to where you want it to go and it just won't quite reach? This is greediness. I should have put 69, not 70. Should I be patient and not make a big deal about $1? Or just put the 69 now? All right, I'm gonna follow my rule. I'm not gonna risk going back into the negative. Interesting, we can't get past this point. Fuck it. I'm out. I just want to at least make some minor tiny profits. Now that I'm out, it'll hit 70. There we go. Like clockwork. And 71, 72. Yep. Yep. That's. Whatever. Whatever. I mean, I don't know. I should have just shut up and just waited. I should have put my sell limit at four around 4022, which I couldn't quite figure where exactly that would be. But I should have put it, since we didn't quite get to 4020 already in the previous candle, I should have put it right at the top of this candle. But whatever. A whole $5 today. Increasing my account size by a whopping 2.44%. Oh, it's actually $7. You know what? I'm in the positive. I'm not gonna complain. But I'm still gonna have my alert set. If things pull back and turn around, we'll see. Oof. Okay. Oof. Okay. I guess it was good. I did sell. Well, we're forming now a. Well, this is the same 50-minute candle from before, but it was forming a supply, popped up here. Now it's back to forming a supply again. All right, I am going to go shower. Okay, this is interesting. Supply formed, rejection from weekly, rejection from this would be a good short. I didn't even think of taking this. I was just so happy to make a whopping $7. But we have somewhat done what I was thinking it would do, but a little bit more than I would like. So on the VIX, we've pulled back, but we've broken past this daily. On ES, we've dropped back down to 4005, but we've dropped down to 4000, which needs to be support. But it looks like the bulls are recovering, but I don't want to jump in and risk losing the little measly profits I've got for the day. Plus, I want to go and shower. How do I put this without being vulgar? Guys will understand. This, gotta wash this several more times. I know, TMI. Sorry, guys. But, it's distracting. This is exactly what. Well, no, I won't say that. Adam Mancini warned that if bulls lose 4,000 and we break back into that chop range of 3975 to 4,000, then it's back to chop. And he mentioned in his newsletter, I don't know if I should talk about his news. I'm not really giving too much information. This is not really uncommon knowledge that breakout trades are not very reliable. They're like 50% reliable. So the breakout of the 4,000 range happened. We almost made it to our next target of 4022, but not quite. But we are regaining 4005, so I don't know. Maybe this should be a long. I don't know. I just want to go shower, have myself a nice breakfast, and relax because I don't think today's going to be very busy. Wait, did I get an assignment? No. That I fixed that. Okay. yeah, you know what? I made only 7 measly dollars. I'm happy. I'm taking it. I'm not trading anymore today. Good to go. I'll update though on what the market's going to do. If I have to make a prediction, the bulls. Never mind, I'll come back to all right, quick update. It looks like we had another spike down. Actually, no, this was the spike down from before that was quickly recovered, and now it's like we're bouncing after all at 4,000. So I was wrong. This would have been a good long after all. Yeah, I should have taken this. I forget when I even made that last video, but I'm pretty sure it was more than the past few minutes. I think it was here, maybe. But bulls are recovering. We're bouncing at 400. We're already at 4010. And on the VIX, it looks like we are rejecting now from this daily. Looks like we really rejected from this SMA. Or is that even a moving average? Whatever, SMA, long-term moving average. So, yeah. So it looks like this gave me what I asked for this morning. A return to the 4,000 level, a bounce back here. All of this came a little bit further than I would like, but yeah. So, with what I had in my account this morning, I could have actually gone in with my full account. I know I shouldn't talk like this. Gone in with a full account and taken this long at 270. And said to sell at 370 or 380 to make up for the commission, and boom, 100 bucks right there. Anyways, all right, before I break for breakfast, I just wanted to give another update. The highest we peaked here after the bounce from 4,000 was about 52, 54 for the option, and look where we rejected. Right at this October low support or trend line that I have. So we have a double supply, the weekly, and this trend line pushing this down, and on VIX we are back above daily support. So, and once again at 4,000. So the bull's inability to reclaim to get past 4,020 or even get near it again is pretty obvious here. I'm gonna move this since they are able to get past 4,010 fairly reasonably well to 4,014. No, yeah, I'll leave it here and then change this. But yeah, again. Per Adam Mancini, and this makes perfect sense. If the bulls cannot keep this above 4,000, we're gonna fall back into that chop range of 3,975 and 4,000. So, but this would have been a good trade nonetheless. This would have been it wouldn't have been it would have been close to 100% profits if you were able to catch the bottom. But this would have been a decent little move, little scalp here. As far as this short, though, it didn't occur to me to take this short. Let's see how that would have looked. Yeah, a nice little scalp available here as well. So, anyways. Okay, a midday update here. This was the option I was using earlier today. I think 402, as you can see, is worth nothing now. This again would have been a wonderful put. Let's show how wonderful a put that is. Let's go to 39, no, not 397. What was the put I used before? I think it was 400. No, I don't remember what it was. I think it was 400. I don't know, but we have. Sorry, this person upstairs is so annoying. It sounds like someone is having a very long fart with a combination of somebody sitting in a leather chair, but it just makes that noise for like 10, 20 seconds constantly, and it's so annoying. I was thinking earlier that if I followed MK strategy, look for supply. Unfortunately, there's no retest on the 15, but his strategy isn't a 15. His strategy is using the 5. So here we have on the 5, supply, 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 retesting this previous supply. I'm pretty sure if I was part of MK's strategy group or his class or whatever, his coaching live trade class, I'm fairly certain they took this short. But using my strategy, this was a good short. I need to review my video and see why I didn't think of doing this. Probably because I was taking this long. Was it here? I forget when I took this long. I think it was probably here. And I didn't quite make it to 4020, and I just sold. Yeah, I think I was waiting for a retest and I went long here. At like 50 something and sold at 60, 59 and sold at 66 or something, barely making much enough money to buy a pizza, a slice of pizza in this economy. But here we formed, and I think I mentioned it too, that we formed a clean supply. And if I remember, was it here or somewhere else a supply was being formed? You know what? I think it was here actually. Yeah, this is where I took my trade and sold up here at this peak. And then this quickly turned around and fell even harder. Then I talked about possibly taking it long again because we hit 400 on ES, or 4,000 on ES, just above it, and they reclaimed, and then this went long. And I was saying how this would have been a good trade to take this long, but this short was confluent with weekly, this October low, two separate supplies formed, and boom, take this low. I really wish you can hear the noise this person's making. It's so annoying. So yeah, here you go. This candle started at 10:45. 10:45, so right around here. Getting in here around $50, $60 and holding. Good trade. Good trade. Over $1,000 of profit could be had on 10 contracts here. From 400 397. So, anyways, that's my update. I need to put my headphones on, otherwise I'm gonna wanna go upstairs and commit acts of whatever. A quick update. I just watched as this new candle formed, and it looks like a clean 50-minute demand is forming here. I thought about jumping in, but then I remember something Adam Mancini has said often in his tweets and in his newsletter. When a level has been tested multiple times, he's very reluctant to take it again, to bid it again, to go long on that level again. What he typically would instead like to see is a flush below and a quick recovery below the level. So, I'm gonna put an alert. Let's back this up a little bit. I'm gonna put an alert to where we had our overnight low. Maybe just above it. If we flush below here, I would like to think that if bulls can recover this quickly, you know what? Let me make it a little bit lower. Because yesterday's low is an interesting spot. Or this trend here. What is this trend again? Oh, yes. This is the bottom of the bull flag. Okay. So we'll put the alert right about here, above this daily. If we flush low down to here and then come back up, that might be a good indicator to take it long. Otherwise, in fact, there'd be several good indicators. We have our strong demand that was formed yesterday in a 30 minute. We have daily and we have the bottom of the bull flag. So this would be a good spot to take it long, flush or no flush. But that's going to be my bullish plan. As far as bearish, after this long drop here, I don't know if I really have a bearish plan unless we really fall below the bull flag and something happens, some news that comes out, catalyst to get this thing to drop. So, yeah. Remember earlier I said that if there's some sort of news catalyst or something that would make this to fall, I don't know what a news catalyst was, but this thing has just been dumping. And 400, remember from earlier today, if you had taken this short, if for some reason you just held on to that 400, I mean that 400 put, this is just incredible. Just incredible. And at any point I could have gotten in after it broke through here, but I thought this was the support where it would come back up because I read Adam Mancini's tweet and our next support was 3963, somewhere here. Nope, that came up. Next support was 2945. That's coming up now. But wow, man. Just a complete drop. We got us a 401 to 394. Not a 10-point drop, but those are rare in this current market. But this is a drop. And we are now pretty much back to where we were. Almost, not quite there. Before our liftoff last week, Thursday, which was at 391. So not that far away. So every time I think this thing's not gonna push down anymore, it does. It does. It keeps pushing further and further down. And I'm irritated because I thought about just getting in and using the next strike price since we're so an hour away from market close. And a few minutes ago, I could have gotten at 30 and exited at 50. And it just keeps pushing down. Look at this. I could have gotten at 50. All right, here we go. Let's just see how far this can go. 57. Let me exit at 67. Of course, watch now it decides to turn around. Typical. Watch I lose what little profits I made today. Messing around here. For VIX, I don't have a next level for a little bit. A little push down. Same thing for ES. No, actually, I take that back. We're at a support on ES. So yeah, this is not good. I'm gonna go ahead and exit here at 51. Oh my God. Yeah. There goes my profits for the day. Just like that. Let me try and be patient and see if this will push back down. I don't think it will, though. Legs is slowly pushing forward, pushing up, higher. I need Vix to get up to the very next level. But you know what? Enough. I'm gonna exit here at 50. Oh my God. Come on, man. Push down so I can. There. I don't wanna suffer a larger loss. Of course, when I decide to go short, this is when the drop suddenly ends. Two things are gonna happen now. Either this thing is gonna go ahead and rally, which I highly, highly doubt, or it's gonna finally drop down. There it is. This is why I say a lot of trading is just luck. A lot of it is luck. It's not so much gambling, it's just luck. You know, I get in here at 59. What did I buy it at? I bought it at 59. 59. And what did I? Oh my God, dude. Where is it? 59. Where's my sell? Okay. I really hate thinkorswim, man. I really do. I'm trying to see. The time is 3:03. Where's my purchase? There it is. Jesus Christ, man. Okay, I bought it at 58 and I sold at 53, so I took a loss. And there it is. There it is. I wanted to sell at 68. I just don't understand how every time I take a trade, it goes against me. It goes against me. And when it goes against me, the longer I wait hoping it will go my way, and it's not, the more money I end up losing. I could have waited for a pullback here to 46, 47, whatever. And then taking the trade and look at this. You can't make this up, man. Let's take a wild guess where it's gonna finally reach. Let's take a wild guess where I wanted it to on VIX. Here we go. So that's where I wanted to sell at the hour. This was the next level I had for VIX, and it's probably gonna blow past this. So there we go. Could have made 30 bucks today. There it is. Keeps pushing. You cannot make this up. You just can't. You can't. I'm gonna put this on a minute scale. On a minute, just to show how ridiculous my luck is. When did I buy in? 15:02. 15:02. Oh my God, dude. No. There's no way. There's no way. There's no way. You're not. I bought this. That's when I sold it. Jesus. Oh, 1458 is when I bought. So here it is. There we go. When I buy is when it turns around and goes against me. When I sell is when it immediately turns around and goes in my favor. This is par for the course, exactly how it always happens. Look at this. Look at this. I buy 1458, it goes against me. I sell 1502. 1502, it starts to go in my favor. It just starts dropping. And it's always the same question. You have a reason for taking the trade. If it goes against you, how long do you wait before you exit? How much patience am I supposed to display before I wait for it to finally go my way? And that's, I get a bunch of different answers from people. Some people say, screw it, give yourself a tight stop loss, and if it doesn't go your way, you always maintain your capital. Other people say, no, you need to give it a lot of breathing room so that it can eventually go your way and you don't waste money in the trade, because if you use too tight of a stop loss, you'll keep getting burned each and every time, and all those burns add up. I'm just, it's just so frustrating, man. It's just so profoundly frustrating. No, I just want to show you this. Look how far this has gone. Look at it. It just keeps plummeting. It keeps plummeting. Right? I get in, it goes back the other way. I get out, plummet. It's almost like the market's like, oh crap, Kevin's in the trade? No. Turn it around. Turn it around. We can't allow Kevin to be able to do, make any money. Turn it around immediately. No. He needs to lose money. Incredible, dude. Well, it's official. We've now dropped 10 points from this morning. Almost. It's almost there. And again, to God, dude, I don't know how many times I'm gonna have to watch this. This is just ridiculous. I know, TMI, sorry. I'm just blown away at the fact that if you had taken this short at 400, which was the option I wanted to use initially, let's back it up. Look how far in the money this is. This is the beauty. This is the beauty of options, but it's a beauty that I've never been able to take advantage of. One option at $55, $60 here, and if you were able to hold it, so let's say, screw it, let's say you said, you know what, I'm gonna hold this till the end of the market. This is just gonna be a sell-off towards the end of the market, and you might decide around 3:30 to take your profits. 700 bucks off of $50. This might drop down a little bit further to like 760, almost 800 at this rate. Meaning if you spent about $5,000 this morning, six, five, seven, whatever, somewhere down in here, and you held it up to here, you've just made $70,000 in one day. And my mind's just going crazy in all the things I can do with 70 G's. First of all, I would be paying off most of my student loans. I'll pay off my car, and I'll still have money left over to put down on buying my own home, which I probably wouldn't do with the market the way it is. But just wow, man. Just an absolute wow. Just got a tweet from Adam Mancini, but it's whatever. 3936 is the next target down. Or it was. 3920 is coming up now, 10 points down. Then 3895. Is it ballsy to go back in again and hope that we make it to 3920? Something else I noticed too, which makes me upset. This is where I went long. No. It was 1448. You know what? I can't remember. I can't remember. It was 1458 that I went long. 1458. 1458. You know what? I don't know. I can't. I was gonna chastise myself thinking that I went long somewhere here, and then this would be the. I mean, I went short here, and this went up, and that's where I exited. But I'm blown away. I'm confused. On a 15-minute candle, it looks like it's just a normal drop. 14:58 is when I got in, and 15:02 is when I sold. So it was within the 15-minute candle. No, I'm not doing, I'm trading anymore. I'm done. I'm sick of this. Not to mention that on SPY, it looks like we're approaching, for me, on the 30 minute, because this is thinkorswim. This is a trash application. But on this chart over here, which is, when I use log scale, it looks like we're approaching the January trend line. Without log scale, we're not. So oh my God, dude. I have no idea. Of course, now that I say I'm not gonna take it short, this thing's plummeting. I still can't believe I got in way down here. Wherever it was, here. Here's where I got in. 1458. Wow. I could have just made over $50 right now. I'm done. That's it.